Hello, I'm Vitaly Kurlin, and will present the joint work with my PhD student Daniel Widdowson. Our paper substantially contributes to a new area of geometric data science by developing isometry invariants with no false negatives and no false positives. Our key object is a cloud of M unlabeled points studied up to isometry. In Euclidean space, isometries decompose into translations, rotations, and reflections and form the full Euclidean group EN. Solve the following isometry problem for clouds of unlabeled points in any Euclidean space. By designing an invariant I, a function on isometry classes, which is complete and Lipschitz continuous. If our points are labeled, the problem is much easier because the whole cloud C in Euclidean space Rn can be uniquely reconstructed up to isometry from pairwise distances. But if these points are not labeled, then in a brute force way we could reconstruct C by m factorial distance matrices. But considering m factorial permutations on all given points is rather impractical. That's why we add one more condition to the isometry problem – computability. In the sense that the invariant I and the metric on invariant values should be computable in a polynomial time in the number of points for a fixed dimension. The related area of geometric deep learning trains neural networks to output isometry invariants, but doesn't provide proofs of completeness and continuity. So one of the simplest invariants known for nearly 20 years is the vector of all sorted pairwise distances. And this is a very strong invariant. It is generically complete in the sense that it distinguishes almost all clouds of unlabeled points in Euclidean space Rn, except possibly singular examples. We extend this invariant without trying to reinvent the wheel. Our first extension, pointwise distance distribution, appeared in the previous work in NeurIPS 2022. For a finite set of m points in any metric space, we can choose a number of neighbors up to m-1 and build the following matrix. It's not a classical distance matrix, but we write distances per point. For example, for the top left vertex in this trapezium example, we write three distances to neighbors. The top right vertex, due to symmetry, accidentally has the same distances to neighbors. That's why it's convenient to collapse these two identical rows into a single one and assign the weight 50%. Initially, these two point clouds of four points were not distinguishable by six pairwise distances. But the new invariant PDD is stronger, the matrices are different. And what is more important, they can be continuously compared by Earth mover's distance, considering these matrices as weighted probability distribution. Our new work extends pointwise distance distributions to stronger invariants. Simplexwise distance distributions in any metric space and simplexwise centered distributions in a Euclidean space, which are proved to be complete and Lipschitz continuous. Instead of fixing one point in pointwise distance distributions, we can now fix a subset of h ordered points. For example, fixing two points in a triangle example, we construct the relative distance distribution, which is a pair of two objects. First, the distance matrix on our subset A, and in this case it is a single number A, the length of that side from P2 to P3, and also the matrix of distances from all other points to our fixed points P2, P3. So these are sides C and B. By choosing all possible unordered subsets A from our given point cloud, we construct a large collection, simplexwise distance distribution. This SDD is a very strong invariant, which distinguished all previous known counterexamples, but can be also computed in a polynomial time in the number of points. In the practically important case of a Euclidean space Rn, we can always shift the center of mass of a given point cloud to the origin, and this reduces the ambiguity to a smaller group of high-dimensional rotations around a fixed center. So similarly here, we consider now a smaller subset of only n-1 points ordered points from a given cloud in addition to its fixed center of origin. We build oriented center distribution as a pair of two objects, the distance matrix D of A and the matrix with m minus n plus 1 permutable columns of distances from any other point of our cloud to with ordered points P0, P1, etc., Pn minus 1. To reconstruct our cloud C up to rigid motion, not only up to isometry, we also need the sign of the determinant on the vectors from every other point Q to the fixed points P0, Pn minus 1. Our main invariant simplex phi center distribution is the unordered collection of classes of all these oriented center distributions for all n minus 1 point subsets considered up to permutations of these points. This slide shows a specific computation for a very simple cloud of 4 vertices of a square with the center of mass at the origin. In the plane, it suffices to fix only one extra point, for example P1 in our set, which in addition to the center of mass will give us the opportunity to uniquely represent the whole point cloud. So for this point P1, we have the following matrix of distances to the pair P1, the origin. In addition to distances written here in the first two rows, we write down signs of areas, so signed areas of triangles. The last sign here is 0 only because the points P1, the center of mass, and P4 are in one straight line. Due to the rotational symmetry, the resulting invariant will consist of a single pair here. The sign of the determinant changes discontinuously from plus to 0 to minus in degenerate cases. That's why to make the resulting invariant Lipschitz continuous, we introduced the key new ingredient, the strength of a simplex, which is the squared volume of a simplex divided by the 2n-1st power of the half perimeter phi. This function is roughly linear, that's why it's Lipschitz continuous with a small constant. This is our main result stating that SCD is a complete invariant. The final slide highlights the major breakthroughs in geometric data science, namely the continuous isometry classifications for finite clouds of points in this paper and the previous work for periodic point sets.